I'm Valentijn Vis. I work since 3 years at industrial design at TU Delft and I'm project leader of G-Motive. G-Motive is a research project. It lasts for about 4 years. And its aim is to change people's behavior by using game elements. And it's mainly about people's behaviors can be changed. Normally that's done by therapy or by services. And we would like to increase the effect of the services by adding products incorporating game elements. The stakeholders of this project can be divided in 3 groups. One of the groups are scientists. And that is divided into researchers in the industrial design and also researchers in these specific topics. Then the second part of the stakeholders are game designers and industrial designers in a broader sense. And the last part of the stakeholders are the application areas, such as the institutes of mental health care, for instance.
My name is Michel Bas and I'm CEO of Runge Serious Games. Runge, one of the oldest serious games companies in the Netherlands, and exists from 1999, focusing specifically on making games for learning, changing behavior and training. One of the reasons we join G-Motive is because we believe that you need to do research in the field of serious gaming. You need knowledge to go further, you need knowledge to innovate. A lot of things are unknown within the serious games, so we are dependent on what the researchers are doing, as they are on what we are doing, so you need this interconnection with each other. What I'm hoping for is that in the end, at the end of this project, we will end up with a tool set, more or less. A tool set of game mechanics and principles we can use in games, serious games, to tackle a specific problem, like in this case, changing behavior. If you compare this to the real world, in mental health care, you've got interventions that solve some problems. And if we have interventions within the serious game that solve some problems, that would be great for us.
It's important to realize that for this project we will use game elements that are effective in video games. So we will not make video games themselves or per se, but use the game elements and see which products are most suitable. And these products can be video games, but can as well be tangible products or systems of rules that people use.
My name is Renske Spijkerman. I'm a senior researcher at PARC. An addiction research institute affiliated with Breider Addiction Care. This is rather large addiction care facility in the Netherlands. We joined G-Motive because we are very interested in new interventions for adolescents who suffer from addiction problems. And this is a great opportunity for us to have new inspiring ideas and possibilities to look for new interventions. So we are very happy to join this group. What I think that we will gain from this G-Motive project are actually 2 things. The first thing is that we will develop together and test a very effective and appealing new intervention that will improve treatment for adolescents with addiction problems. And then the second thing we will gain, I think, from this project is actually more abstract. But I think this collaboration is very inspiring already, because this group of people has a different point of view, different ideas. They totally have a different vocabulary. And together, when we brainstorm about ideas, we get inspiration. And I think this will provide new initiatives and totally different ideas that maybe will help also eventually to improve treatment and to do interesting research.
Yeah, our deliverance will be mainly scientific knowledge on how game elements can affect behavior and motivation, and also that we have some proof that this game knowledge can be inserted into products, so it can be used in the design, and that design will be tested in the application areas.